Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Christmas Room. There's a new camera that came. It's called the Sony A7S Mark III. Right here. A beautiful, wonderful camera. And you're actually watching it right now. You're actually looking at the camera. This is what it looks like in the Christmas room. It was a great big decision on whether I should get the A7S Mark III or get the new Canon R5. Okay, so I went through a very, very scientific way of picking out which camera I should buy. It was very involved. It was stressful on the computer systems. I tried to input as much information as I could, and I wound up ordering both of them. And whichever one came in first, that's the one I was gonna buy. And that's exactly what happened, to tell you the truth. I ordered the Canon R5, and I ordered the Sony A7S Mark III, which is what you're looking at right now. So the A7S Mark III came in 4 days after I put it up on order, and I'm still waiting for the R5. So they're dribbling in, from what I understand. Now, that's not a good way for you to decide whether you should buy the R5 from Canon or the A7S III from Sony. What you should do is kind of look at it maybe a little bit differently. What you can do is look and see if you're more video-oriented, because if you're more video-oriented, very, very solid bulletproof systems from a lot of their cameras, like this, see, you can tell right here what it is, the Sony A6100. These cameras are really, really very solid. That doesn't mean the Canon is not just as good, but in some areas, I consider the Sony better. So you could choose that, but that really isn't the way I would go either, all right? I would actually look at two things in helping you to decide which camera it is that you want. So right now, we're on my Nikon Z6. Let me go over here and add the, there we go. So I've got the Sony A7 III. Let's check. Before I open my mouth and say something, I'm going to, okay. So I put my hand over the lens of the Sony A7S Mark III, and now I'm going to move over and put my hands and cover the lens of the Nikon Z6. All right, so these are both high-end cameras, one from Nikon and one from Sony. And now you know the Sony is the one on the left. The Nikon, I'm looking at my monitor so to see what's happening. And the Nikon is the one on the right. Did I do that correctly? Is the Nikon the one on the right? Yep, that's the one. Okay. I got my own self confused. So now you can compare them with a split screen to see. Okay, so I could tell you just from the few days and a few times that I have used the Sony and that I have used the Nikon, the Nikon, no, let's make it the Sony, is almost bulletproof in its focus. So if I just kind of walk all the way back here and then turn around and stop for a moment. Okay, now I'm not doing the full walk of focus because I would actually come over here, which is out of the frame a little bit. Then I'd come over here. But because I'm using a reduced section of the frame, I'm just going to come straight up here. Okay, now I'm going to step out of the frame completely. I'm going to go over to the side, kind of look in the mirror, make sure. Why didn't you guys tell me my hair wasn't combed? Okay, now it's combed. Okay, so now I'm going to come back in to the center. And you can kind of see that one camera does better than the other. That doesn't mean that the Nikon is bad. I actually own it. That's my camera. Actually, these cameras in here are all under my jurisdiction. So I have, what do we got? Let's go through the list so you can see. I've got the Sony A7S Mark III. So this is the new boy, the new kid on the block, okay? As they call it. And this is the old new kit on the block. So I've been using this guy since February of this year. And before February of this year, I used the A73, the Sony A7 Mark III or the Sony A7 III, whatever you want to call it. But when Nikon updated their firmware, I went over and bought me a Nikon. And the reason is I got a lot of Nikon lenses, which brings me back. Let's go back to the Sony, which brings me back to the conclusion, or the suggestion's a better word, as to what camera should you pick? And the camera you should pick is, don't look at the camera completely. Look at the lenses that you would like to buy and what they're available at, and don't stop there. Okay? Look at the pricing on the lenses, because the pricing on the lenses is quite unique. And make sure you can afford the lenses that you want to put on the particular camera that you want. Now, I don't have an R5 here. I only have, I like doing this one here. I like doing the split because I could see what camera I have been using for almost a year, which is on your right, which is the Nikon, and which is the new camera, which is on your left. So I'm on a split screen thing. So I can also, if I wanted to, I can actually add, let's see what else I can add in here. I can add the third one, okay? And that brings us to the A6100. So all of these are wonderful cameras, okay? Now, there's another camera that's kind of hiding, and I'm going to do a whole video on this camera, and that is this guy here. I'm clicking on the things that change the cameras. I'm clicking this one here. So what is this camera? This is a camera where the lens is built in. It's got no recording limit, and it does great 4K. It's actually a complete package all in one. So the negative thing on this particular one, I'll do another video on the ZV-1. So this is the ZV-1, and I want to walk around with this and kind of like vlog style, where you walk and you talk to the camera. Hey, I am a talking to the camera. So this is the ZV-1. So this is a secret under the radar super camera because of the pricing and also because of what it does. And then the next step up in pricing from lower to higher is what I have on hand is the A6100. Where are you? Over there. So now, I would like to compare this camera with the M6 Mark II, but I don't have that here, but I asked for it, and I might get one in here to test it, and then I will compare it with that one. So let's go back to the topic of this one, which is a $3,500 camera, which is basically bulletproof. You got to determine what do you think of the quality. Now, don't forget, I'm the one that's fine-tuning the colors and all that kind of stuff. And because I'm Greek, many times I talk with my hands, and it confuses the focus system on the camera. And the way you can tell if it's confused or not is you can see the lights, the lights on the Christmas tree blink. And not blink. They actually kind of like change. Like, watch, if I put my hand up in front, see how the Christmas tree lights change? And then if I put my hand down, I'm watching my own face. So if I actually show you, this is what's actually being used right now to record, is this, which I can put up to four cameras in 4K 60p, although I'm not using 60p on any of the cameras, but I am using 4K, and you can see how that focuses. So I could switch over to, let's say, the Nikon Z6. So this little boy over here was actually my number one camera for almost three quarters of a year. So if I put that up and don't make it so that the lights glare, and I bring it back down, so that's how that one responds in the focus. So see how this one doesn't do as well as, let's see, where is that Sony? So let's give Sony that test too. So we're going to put the Sony up there, and it doesn't even want to grab it at all. Okay, I think it's trying to look for a face. So I'll put that up there. And if I go up higher, if I go left, if I go right. So the Sony's making a liar out of me. Okay, so let's do that over and over until I find out what I'm doing wrong. So that time I did something right. So it's grabbing the focus. Now, why wasn't the grabbing the focus a minute ago? Let's go back over to the Nikon. And while we're at the Nikon, and I'm saying that the Sony is bulletproof, right? So, and that's what I found over a period of, let's say, 3/4 of a year. It's almost a year, okay, but not quite. That the Nikon's new focus system, which is, they call it the 3.0, whatever we're up to, 3.2, I find that I haven't been able to break the Sony focus system yet. So I put that up, it focuses. I put it down. So now I don't know what I did before. Maybe I left too much of my face up. So, hi, how you doing? And this is with glasses. Without glasses, all the focus systems works better, okay? So let's go over to the 6100, and I'll put that up there. Now the 6100 doesn't focus as well as the higher priced one. See how it doesn't grab that very easily? It'll grab it if I put it in the right place. So I come back and forth. I'm kind of looking at myself, and I have my glasses on, which makes it more difficult. So I think it needs to be more closer to the center of the screen. How about this ZV-1? Let's take a look at that guy. Okay, so what happens when I cover my face with that one? Oh, that one grabs it really quick. $750. $750 with a Zeiss lens, a 1.8 Zeiss lens. So that's why this camera's in the running for something really, really good. And for something similar in price, this camera and the A6100, the M6 Mark II from Canon would probably be in a similar ballpark. But we'll wait till that camera comes back in. So I'm going to do a lot more videos with the Sony. I'm going to show you the body. I got different lenses to put on there. I've got all these really cool screens where I could put three. And let's put the ZV-1 in there too. We'll make it a four screen setup. Okay. There we go. Four screens. Split screen. It's kind of like a broadcast station, so we can identify them. Okay, the one that I'm pointing at, which is your bottom left, is the 6100. Okay, the one that I'm pointing at now is the A. No, this is not an A. This is the ZV-1. So let's identify these so we know what we're doing. Okay, so that one is the ZV-1, bottom right. The 6100 I can't reach. It's on the other side of the room. Okay, so that top right is a Nikon, and this is the Sony. Okay. So top left is the Sony A7S Mark III. That's the new kid on the block, okay? Then the one on the right side of it is the Nikon Z6. Then the bottom left is the A6100, which is a sleeper camera. This camera does really, really well. And then the bottom right is the ZV-1. And on the ZV-1, I even have a remote control here with a built-in tripod. And if I close the tripod, let's go to the ZV-1 real quick. This tripod controls the zoom. So I can actually zoom in and out. And if I close the tripod and put the camera on here, I could talk all day. Hey, how you doing? It's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I'm here to talk to you. So with this guy, I can zoom out and you can see all the lights that I've got going. I can zoom in and I can zoom. That's the full strength of the zoom. I'd have to come down here. Okay. So let's back it up just a little bit and I just keep it right here. So just for fun, I can push and zoom. So we got a plethora is the better pronunciation of cameras. All right, so look for the next video. I'm going to put different kinds of lenses on this bad boy, and some of it is going to surprise you. Some of the things that I'm able to do with this camera are unexpected, unannounced, and I haven't seen very many people do it. So there's a magic button on the A7S Mark III. So if you're subscribed, thank you. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm asking for you to, how do they say it nowadays? Smash. We're making it into potatoes, smash potatoes. Okay. But thank you for watching. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happened. happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.